see any limitations with what Kohlberg did in his experiment? For some reason, Kohlberg only tested boys and men in his task. So people have challenged his theory on this basis and have subsequently looked at gender differences. In more modern approaches to how we think about moral reasoning, people have also examined specific domains of reasoning within moral reasoning itself and how kids understand those. And finally, some have also considered the role of parents. Carol Gilligan, who is actually a student of Kohlberg, was one of the first people to challenge his theory. She repeated Kohlberg's study, but this time she tested men and women as participants. What she ended up finding was that women were most often in stage 3, and men were most often in stage 4. Gilligan is not arguing here that women are less morally advanced than men. What she found was that, more often, women gave reasons like Joe shouldn't give his father the money because Joe sacrificed and worked hard in good faith. Whereas men more often gave reasons like Joe has the right to refuse to give his father the money because in a general sense, respect for property is important for order in society, etc., etc. What Gilligan argues is that this is actually a reflection of a cooperative kind of orientation versus a justice kind of orientation. Going back to Kohlberg's stages, stage 3 is more about how Joe and his father are interacting and whether or not they're holding up their ends of the bargain, whereas stage 4 tends to be argued from the point of general rights and whether or not it was a just thing to do. Gilligan argues that by failing to test half of the population, Kohlberg may have overestimated the importance of progressing through the stages, and that maybe there are just different kinds of moral reasoning that vary across people.